And from the fields to the 21st century, one local farm has turned to the power of the web to help them finish a pretty unique project. News Channel 5's Jill Glavin spent her day at the farm and joins us live now. Hi, Jill.
Hi, Bridget. Well, Sugar Mountain Farm is a family farm right in the heart of Vermont. We first went there 2 years ago when we heard about the farm's unique solution to a shortage of local butchers. And now, thanks to the power of the internet, their project is almost done.
So it's an arched roof.
Walter Jeffries is standing atop the latest addition to his farm. It's clear that it's a work in progress.
And then this is the future hot kitchen and smokehouse.
But it's work he's done entirely on his own.
It's a matter of starting building something very small, models, and then gradually building bigger and bigger versions.
What he's building is an on-farm butcher shop. Jeffries and his wife Holly have run Sugar Mountain Farm for decades. They have 300 pigs on this land, and every week a group goes to the butcher. For Holly, that means a drive to Massachusetts and back.
Not driving for the entire day to get down there will be excellent.
The Jeffries have spent years getting the training, permits, and materials they need to start butchering their pigs here at home. And for that last push, they turn to a different source, WebTool Kickstarter.
I didn't really know what to expect. It was a big unknown.
That unknown turned into more than $33,000, donated from people across the country who liked the idea and will get some meat in return.
If all goes as planned, the Jeffries are planning to be operating out of this facility on the farm by this summer.
The pigs should be content going about their usual business, but for Walter and Holly, the work will be well worth it. They expect the $300,000 they'll invest here to pay itself off in less than 3 years.
And it feels close, the idea of being able to cut our own pigs this summer. It's been years and now we're talking months.
Well, the Jeffries took their farm to the internet. Before they turned to Kickstarter, they have a blog that keeps up with their progress on the butcher shop and on the farm. You'll find a link to that in the As Seen On section of WPTZ.com. Live in the newsroom tonight, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5.